Welcome to the Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour. Super Talk Mississippi 93.7 Spotlight is on Northwest Community College, and you can listen to our live stream at supertalknorthms.com. Just click on the link for the Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour. Here's your host, Gary Darby.
Sitting in the LitGoMetals.com studio on this Thursday, October 27th, we will do yet another Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour program for you between now and 10. I've got job opportunities to discuss with you on the Northwest main campus. We'll get to that here momentarily. And then we will discuss things in the financial aid world as the Director of Financial Aid, Lakeshia Hibbler, comes back onto the program. Speak with her at around 9:15, and when we're done with that conversation, Dr. Saundra Bishop is back on to talk with us about entertainers, the show choir and a concert and things coming up in the music world. So that is how we roll today. Lakeshia Hibbler, financial aid discussion, Saundra Bishop, and the entertainers. We'll get to that. And when we're done with those two interviews, we'll take a look at tonight's football game. We'll tell you how the Rangers will finish up the regular season and where. And then that moves them into playoffs for the ninth straight season. We will get into all of that on today's program. Whether you're finding us online at supertalk.fm, you're listening to us at supertalk93.7, streaming us in other forms throughout your Alexa device or whatever it may be. You can always reach us with a text message line straight into the LitGoMetals.com studio, 662-426-1093, 426-1093. On Twitter at GDARB65, and the Facebook page, North Mississippi Spotlight with Gary Darby. We put up a few more things there this morning. So before we get into our financial aid discussion and then the entertainers, let's tell you a few things, as I mentioned, in the job world that you can now apply for. That's often jobs, you know that. You can always go to northwestms.edu and check that out. But the Northwest Center for the Performing Arts, the PAC, is now looking for part-time temporary positions for their event starting in January and then following through into that 2023 spring season calendar. And so they're looking for technical crew responsible for assisting in the lead-in, the load-in, the load-out, and the setup of the touring productions equipment, and running crew for performances and events, a ticketing agent, obviously responsible for box office ticket sales with guests over the phone and in person. And then there's also the need for concession personnel. And you know that's responsible for the sale of food and non-alcoholic beverages in the concession area. Now, the way to find out more or to apply for any of these jobs for the upcoming season 2023 in the pack there on the main campus in Senatobia, it's nwccpac.org. nwccpac.org. Hopefully, you got all of that. You can get more information on the jobs that are available at Northwest Community College and the new Performing Arts Center. And I know we're going to have other things going on as well. I think Kerry Goff's going to be back on with us at some point discussing the ticket plans and things that are now out there now that we know those and we can get those out to you. But you can go find all of that information. Very, very good website. Already been perusing through it as the day has gone along. And that is, again, nwccpac.org, where you can look at how you can support the Performing Arts Center, the events and the tickets, how to get those season tickets if you want, summer theater programs, the film series, all of that that we've talked about before here on the show, and then the employment opportunities. You can go check it all out. nwccpac.org is the way to do that. Later on today, you can find this program anywhere you can find your podcasts. It will be in that form, so you can check it out. Later this afternoon, 9:13, we're underway, and next we will discuss some financial aid at Northwest Community College. Stay with us.
You're listening to the Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour, your connection to Northwest Mississippi Community College on Supertalk Mississippi 93.7 and stream live at supertalknorthms.com. Just click on the link for the Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour.
I do this a lot, right? I get the guests on the phone and we start talking, and then I realize, hey, we need to carry the conversation to the airwaves. It's 9:16. Miss Lakeshia Hibbler, how you doing today?
I'm good. How are you?
Things are well. Beautiful day today in store for us, weather-wise. All that's good. Getting to chat with great people like you. And a little bit later on, Saundra Bishop's going to talk with us about the entertainers. But we're going to discuss financial aid again. How have things been going on in the office? Have we been busy?
We've been pretty busy. Getting ready, processing students' refunds. I'm trying to go out into the high schools to help students complete their FAFSA so they'll be ready for school starting in August. So we've been getting out about and keeping busy in the office as well.
Good deal. Director of Financial Aid Lakeshia Hibbler is on the phone with us, and we're going to talk about FAFSA. You mentioned that, and this is, if you don't mind, maybe last time we had you on, maybe when we discussed this, there was a parent or prospective student that doesn't know exactly what we are talking about there. What is FAFSA?
So FAFSA stands for Free Application for Federal Student Aid, and that is filled out by students that are wanting to attend college. It gets them qualified for federal student loans, Pell Grant, Teach Grant, FSCOG grants. It's all those grants and scholarships and loans, and as well as if you're applying for any Northwest institutional scholarships, that FAFSA is required for all students that want to use that aid to pay for their tuition. It also helps them be eligible for state grants like MESG, HELP, MTAG, all those scholarships. The FAFSA helps them and qualifies them for those aids.
And I know this opened for the 2023-2024 school year in the first of the month. Is that correct?
Correct, yeah. It just opened October 1st. So students and parents can go out and fill out that free application for federal student aid, and they'll be using their 2021 taxes if they file taxes for that year.
Gotcha. And you recommend that everyone, no matter who you are, whether you think you're going to get anything or not, everybody needs to fill this form out.
Yes, everyone needs to go ahead and fill that form out, no matter if you think your parents make too much or if you think you make too much. Or if you don't even want to use federal aid, you still need to complete that FAFSA because it qualifies you for institutional scholarships as well as state aid also.
Let's talk about those institutional scholarships now, if you don't mind. Kind of describe those and in detail. Maybe is there a deadline or something we need to be thinking of?
Yes. So those also opened up on October 1st, and they close on April 1st. So if you took your ACT, you have to take ACT. So if you took your ACT, if you have ACT of 19 and below, you can qualify for $550 per semester. If you have an ACT between 20 to 23, you can get up to $800. ACT 24 to 27, you can get up to $1,600. And your ACT 28 and above, you can get up to $3,325. And all that goes towards your tuition, your room, and your board.
You know, in the times that I've had some students on, the various ones, you know, they start talking about all these scholarships and things they get and the fact that they may actually be making money by going to Northwest Community College, you know?
Yes. That is very true.
And there's been some great students that I've had an opportunity to speak with along the way. All right, a lot of conversation around the country about the Student Debt Relief Plan. Fill us in on Northwest Community College and how all of that is working.
Okay, so yes, students who have loans, they can do that student debt relief plan that Biden has put into effect. What it is, if you receive a federal Pell Grant, you could be eligible for up to $20,000 in debt relief. And if you didn't receive a Pell Grant but you received loans, you could be eligible for up to $10,000 in debt relief. All you have to do is go to studentaid.gov for more information, and it will let you give you all the information you need, and you can apply right there. It takes less than 5 minutes to fill out the little application. It's just requesting your name, your date of birth, and your Social Security number. They'll be able to go in and look up your Pell Grant and loans to see if you qualify. And your funds, if you receive those funds, like Pell or loans, they would have to be dispersed before July 1st of 2022 for you to be eligible for the debt relief.
And so when will those loan payments maybe restart?
Well, if you have current loans now, and if you were, what Biden did when COVID happened, he did a debt, where he did an extension where you wouldn't have to pay on your loans, and it's been extended like 3 or 4 times. But that extension does end December 31st of 2022. So the payment pause includes a suspension of loan payments It was 0% interest rate, and it stopped collections on loans that were in default. So all that will end on December 31st of 2022, unless Biden is nice to extend it again. I'm not sure if that's going to happen. So everyone just needs to be prepared to start back those loan payments after December 31st.
Excellent. So if one needs to go and find all of this information out, or is there anything else maybe you need to mention before I let you go?
No. If they want to find out any information on anything with federal aid, with the student debt relief plan, or the loan extension with your student loan payments, they can go to studentaid.gov. And all the information is provided on studentaid.gov.
Look, thank you for your time this morning, and as always on this show, you do a great job with us talking about that office and the things that we need to do. And again, just a reminder, you know, just because you may be sitting here thinking my kid can't get anything, or as a student, maybe I'm not going to get any help to go to school, please go fill those forms out, and we'll give you more details on that. My friend, thanks for being with us. Have yourself a good Thursday.
Thanks, you too.
All right, bye. That is Dr. Lakeshia Hibbler, the Director of Financial Aid on the Northwest Campus. And as she mentioned, you know, FAFSA is there for you. You can go to that website and find out all of that. It's studentaid.gov. Studentaid.gov. And it takes you directly to federal student aid. You see the FAFSA form. You see the loan and grants. You see the loan repayment. You see the loan forgiveness. It's all there. And all you have to do, if you're new to the FAFSA process, let's just say moms, dads, or adults who are wanting to go back to school at this particular point in time, and you just click on Start Here, and you start your process off, and you fill in all that information. And again, as she said, it will go on based off your 2021 tax returns. So you need to have those. I should have asked her about a checklist and things that we needed to get this process, once you get this process going and move forward. And then if you're a returning user, maybe you have already, you know, filled out the form before, there's the place for you. And then you can just find out all that you need to do for the 2023-24 FAFSA and the deadlines and things that you have along the way. So it is already started. It did so at the first of the month, and you can go through and get that done. So be sure to go to studentaid.gov and get busy. And we thank our friend Lakeshia Hibbler from the Financial Aid Office, Director of Financial Aid, for being on and doing that with us. 662-426-1093, that is our text message line. You can join us, talk to us, speaking however you want, whatever's going on in your world. Go to our Facebook page. Stay in touch on Twitter at GDARB65. Stream us in the various forms that you can, or just keep listening right here on Super Talk Soulman, North Mississippi 93.7. I will remind you that coming up later on today, between 1 and 2, after Gerard does the midday program, it is Thursday, so we get Steve Azar's In a Mississippi Minute. You'll get to hear part 2 of an interview with the legendary television host and fisherman Bill Dance. That comes on between 1 and 2 In a Mississippi Minute with Steve Azar, presented by visitmississippi.org. You can hear the show each Thursday and Friday right here from 1 to 2 on Supertalk 93.7 in North Mississippi. It's also available at supertalk.fm and everywhere you listen to your podcast, much like this one will be a little bit later on today. It is the Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour on a Thursday, October 27th. Next, we'll talk the entertainers, the show choir, and more. Dr. Saundra Bishop comes on with us. She's the director, also teaches piano and other things in the music department. We'll get with Saundra Bishop coming up on the other side of the break. Today's Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour rolls on.
This hour is everything Northwest. Your connection to Northwest Community College and powered by Sycamore Bank. Thanks for joining us on the Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour. Join the conversation by texting 662-426-1093.
9:30, it is Thursday morning. And we, on Thursdays, as you know, discuss Northwest Community College. We did some financial aid discussion with Dr. Lakeshia Hibbler. And we encourage you, if you have that student going, to get that FAFSA form and fill it out. I've had mixed, you know, people texting in and doing things. Some say, you know, the process didn't take that long and was okay. And then I've had others that say it may take you a while. Don't get frustrated. Roll through it and get what you can get, right? And I think we all need to fill that out. And wherever you might be doing things, take your time, get that done, and let's get those kids into the college, wherever it might be. But today we're talking Northwest Community College, and we're talking with Dr. Saundra Bishop now. She's back on the phone with us. Good morning. How are you?
I'm great. How are you?
Things are good. We talked about financial aid, and I know that you have to deal with that as well, with your students, getting them into the music programs and your entertainers and things, and talking with that. Very important, because I know there are scholarships and different things available that can help students get into your world, too.
Absolutely. We scholarship, everybody who's in choir has some sort of scholarship, so it's super important for those things to get done so we can get them here.
So yeah. we were going to talk entertainers, but I kind of went back and I've looked at different things, and I see, you know, you're teaching piano, you're doing other things in the music department. What is a typical day for you? What you know, like I've interrupted your day already, and you know, and we're doing things here at 9:30. But what is a typical, and I don't know if there is one, but what's a normal teaching day for you?
Normal teaching day, probably. I have something almost every hour. I'm skipping out on my piano class for a few minutes here today, which they don't mind.
Don't tell Dr. Heindel, right?
That's right, that's right. I've got theory class with my sophomores at 10 o'clock every day, and then either piano class or a choral rehearsal at 11, and then entertainers meets every day at 1, and then another piano class or another choral rehearsal at 2, and then you build in accompanying rehearsals for the singers for their student recitals or the instrumentalists for their recitals. And so it gets to be a busy day.
How much do you still play? Obviously you're teaching, but and some of that might be you're playing and showing and demonstrating. But how much do you get to play yourself, whether it's, you know, there just within the building and what you're doing there or out in the world?
Yeah, I don't play a lot here as far as just my own practice time, but I mean, I do a lot of accompanying for the choirs and for the students, and then get to play out in the community some, playing for different high school choirs, their concerts. I've got North Mississippi Symphony coming up this weekend, so I get to play with them on one of the pieces that they're doing. So just a little part in that this weekend, and so I get to do some, and still love to play a lot.
All right, look, I've kind of derailed what we're probably supposed to talk about, but we're going to continue one more step with this.
Yeah,
because you've mentioned orchestras, you've mentioned choirs. Is that, you know, the genre, so to speak, that you like to stay in, or do you branch out and do you play other forms? If you get me, like, there's a time that comes through here where in North Mississippi there's a ragtime concert, you know, I mean, there's
right,
contests,
yeah,
and things that go on, and
yes,
and different areas of the world. So do you branch and do a little bit of all of it, or are you maybe focusing on one type?
Well, classical style is that's really my genre, you know, that's what I was trained in, but I love to dabble in the other stuff, the ragtime stuff. That is I love to watch those performers, you know, playing that style, and do a lot of church work. And so I dabble in the other things, but the classical is mostly what I work on when I'm working.
I always like to watch myself, and never, I've got tiny hands, and so it just never would work out for me. I tried guitar, couldn't do that either, so they put a drumstick in my hand,
yeah,
and it was all good.
Well, I understand that. I actually tried guitar, too. I thought I could do that, but no way.
That's right.
Maybe a little sympathy for my students trying to learn piano as a new instrument.
All right, let's talk about the entertainers and that group itself, and for those that may be listening, exactly, explain what the entertainers are.
Yes, the entertainers is our pop vocal ensemble. And we've got a concert coming up a week from today. It's titled Come Rain or Come Shine, and it's going to be just a mix of songs. My students thought we're singing about the weather, but it's really about, you know, kind of the dark days in life and then making it through to the brighter times. So variety of songs, swing, jazz style. We're doing Prince, Purple Rain. We're doing Lady Gaga song. The guys are singing a barbershop Elvis arrangement of barbershop arrangement of an Elvis tune. And then the girls are doing a Proud Mary. So it's just a variety of songs, and it's going to be a lot of fun.
How many hours are you guys putting in to get ready for this?
Oh, man, they are really, really, really putting in the work lately. It's kind of, you can't give it all you've got until right before. So they are putting in extra hours, probably at least 3 or 4 hours a day right now. We're going to be here Sunday evening. We're going to be here in the evenings next week. They've been working in the evenings this week on their own, polishing things and getting it all ready. But it's going to be great.
You mentioned that, I think you said, the girls are going to be doing Proud Mary. Is that right?
That's right.
Who's going to do the deep, right? How are you working that out? The whole deep bass part there that goes in that song.
Let me tell you, with these girls, that these young ladies are phenomenal, and we've got a girl that can carry that bass part.
Really?
Yeah.
That's awesome.
So let me just kind of mention, I don't know if people have seen it, but we actually did a music video of this song, Proud Mary. It was a collaborative effort. Dr. Andrew Dale and Reese Norris, and we put together this music video, and it's on YouTube. Northwest Community College, Proud Mary, and you can find it on the Northwest Choir's Facebook page as well. But it is phenomenal, and people really need to check that out, and it'll kind of give you an idea of what to expect at the concert, too.
Okay, so I'm clicking on the computer here, all right? I'm trying to follow with you, and you said we go to YouTube, and then,
yeah.
then we go where now?
I searched Northwest Mississippi Community College, Proud Mary.
Okay.
And it was the first thing that popped up.
All right, good. Well, I'll tell you what I'm going to try and do. I'm going to try and get that and pull that up and then maybe play a flash of it here before
That'd
the show
be awesome.
Gets done today.
Sure.
Because you've got my interest piqued in all facets and forms. So as we've gone through with this and we've talked about the performances and we talked about financial aid and we've talked about everything, what is a way now for someone who may have their interest piqued? Like, I think I want to be involved with this, or my son, daughter would be good with this. What should they do?
For sure. We have, for rising seniors, high school seniors, we've got a thing called Immersion Day that is early in the spring semester. I think it might be 1st of February, around that time. I'd have to look at the dates, but it's called Immersion Day. And students can come and spend a day here on campus. They get to participate with our choirs. They get to watch us sing. They get to sing with us. They get to tour campus. They get to hang out. And they also get to audition for scholarships. So that's a great time for people to come. They can also schedule an audition at any time. They just contact myself or Reese Norris, and they can, you know, set up a time to audition. But that's really all it takes. Just audition and let us know your interest and your background, and then we go from there.
Excellent. All right. Well, I think I have it here.
Okay.
And
yeah.
I think I'm going to, here we go. I'm going to give them a little listen on the way
Great.
Into the break. All right.
Awesome.
Thank
Sounds
you
good.
So much for being with us, and I appreciate your time today.
Thank you.
Lived a good job in the city. Working for the man every night and day. And I never lost 1 minute of sleep, because I worried about the way things might have been. Big wheels keep on turning, Proud Mary keep on burning. For the man every night and day, and I never lost 1 minute of sleep, because I'm worried about the way things might have been. Big wheel keep on turning, Proud Mary keep on burning, and we're rolling, rolling.
when I never did lose 1 minute of sleep, cause I was worried about the way things might have been. Big wheels keep on turning, Rosemary keep on burning, and we're rolling, rolling, rolling on the river.
Cleaned a lot of plates down in Memphis. Pumped a lot of tank down in New Orleans. But I never saw the good side of the city till I hit the
Okay, then. That's a little taste of what you will get. That's the Proud Mary from the Northwest Entertainer, the ladies. And that was a tremendous, tremendous. I'm impressed. All right, so look, go find out when all of that is going on. Get there and enjoy that. And thanks to Saundra, who pointed out we could go find that quickly and play that for you on today's program. My friends, it's what we like to do, and we're telling you all about Northwest Community College today. Between now and 10 o'clock, there is more to come. We'll come back and put a finish, wrap it up, tell you what's coming up tomorrow on the show as well. Stay with us. It's 9:42.
Hey! We're talking Rangers this hour. Thanks for joining us for the Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour. It's a special conversation about Northwest Community College. There's a campus near you and more to come. And you can join the conversation by texting 662-426-1093.
All true, and we appreciate you being around the program today, the Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour, about to put the finishing touches on the program. We thank Dr. Lakeshia Hibbler for being on with us talking about financial aid and the things we need to do to get ready for the next school year 2023-24, and then Dr. Saundra Bishop for talking with us about the entertainers and turning on to that performance that I played for you a little moment ago. So if you were just tuning in and you're like, why are we playing music, right? One of the entertaining groups, the young ladies singing there on the Northwest campus, and there's video with that goes on that shows different locations, different places, even in the city of Memphis, as they were talking about the Big River, right, doing all that kind of stuff. You can go check it out again on the old YouTube if you want. You can find that good production put on. And then, as mentioned, there'll be a concert coming up for the entertainers and more. And find out all the information you need at northwestms.edu. That's for everything educationally or anything along the way. Northwest football, ranked number 3 in the country. They have already secured a playoff spot. 8-0 overall. They're a perfect 5-0 inside the North Division of the MACCC. Well, the Northwest Rangers are on the road at Northeast tonight. Kickoff is at 6:30, and all the coverage begins on NWCCRangers.com at 6. Now, there's a lot on the line for the opponent, Northeast. They're one of 3 teams that are trying to secure the second seed out of the North. Northwest has clinched the top spot because they've already beaten Itawamba and East Mississippi, who are the other 2 teams that still have opportunities at second place in the North. Northeast obviously must beat Northwest tonight to get their possibility of a playoff spot. So the Northeast Tigers at Tiger Stadium in Boonville with that opportunity. Kickoff again is scheduled at 6:30. For that, pregame coverage with Tyler Springs begins at 6 on Ranger TV. That's NWCCRangers.com/watch. So the rivals Northwest, Northeast, There'll be two really good bands, one would assume, that'll be going at it again. And then the football game, of course, the main attraction, so to speak, kicking it off at 6:30. Rangers trying to go unbeaten. They will have a home playoff game coming up. We'll get you all that information and more. I know that women's soccer is going to be in the Region 23 tournament and things going on soon as well. Check out NWCCRangers.com for all of that information as to the when and the where for all of that and any of the other sporting news you would like, again, at NWCCRangers.com. Maybe all of them will give you true facts and not sprinkle in wrong games along the way, okay? Thanks for being with us. The Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour is done for this day of October. So long.